Welcome to the Steam Channel. In this HO Scale Product Spotlight, we'll be looking over the New Haven I-5 Hudson Brass Hybrid from Broadway Limited Imports. The model comes in a blister package, as you can see here. Let's get her unpacked and ready to look over. We selected the 1409 in the McGinnis Fantasy Scheme as I thought this looked nice on the model. As a kid, my dad used to run a pair of O-scale F units in this scheme, and this engine brings back memories of operating those engines years ago. These I-5 Hudsons have handcrafted brass boilers, cabs, and tender bodies, which sit atop die-cast chassis. The locomotive has a 5-pole can motor with skew-wound armature and a precision drive mechanism engineered for continuous heavy load towing and smooth, slow-speed operation. The New Haven Railroad received 10 464 Hudson locomotives from the Baldwin Locomotive Works in 1937. These Hudsons were the last steam engines the New Haven Railroad would purchase, and many New Haven Rail fans may argue that they were the most beautiful. The locomotives featured streamlined boilers that were gloss black with stainless steel stripes and trim. This streamlining was done with ease of maintenance in mind, so the running gear was left unobstructed. These Hudsons served as speedy power for the shoreline passenger trains that service New Haven and Boston. The most recognizable extra fare trains these engines hauled were the Merchants Limited, the Senator, and the Yankee Clipper. Broadway Limited's rendition of the I-5 is a pretty sharp-looking model. I can't say that I'm a New Haven fan per se, but this locomotive will make a nice fine addition to the Age of Chris Roundhouse. Don't worry, I'll find a better name for the Roundhouse. Starting up at the pilot, you'll see the grab iron and handrail detailing, rivet detail, the nice side skirting, and the nice rounded smoke box door. The class lights can be seen mounted to the side of the skyline casing. It's kind of interesting that depending on the angle that one is looking at the headlight, it may appear that there's not a headlight lens in the headlight, but rest assured, there is one there. In this pan down the boiler, you can spot the builder's plate, the throttle linkage, piping detail, and the handrail spanning the boiler. On the fireman's side of the locomotive, you'll also notice the whistle mounted just behind the lighted number boards. The cab on this model is sleek and smooth. You can spot a few grab irons on the back of the cab along with some nice cab window framing. The boiler back head was nicely finished with gauges and valves, and an engineer and fireman figure can be seen in the cab. While nice, the detail on the boiler back head was a bit hard to get focused in the camera, but I tried my best to show you guys this detail. My favorite part of the locomotive is the firebox, ash pan, and piping detail around the firebox. Broadway Limited did an excellent job with this detail, and it makes the model look all the more realistic. The injector and injector piping detail also accentuate a more simplistic trailing truck design. This truck frame highlights the journal boxes and heart rockers, but is not overly busy. You can also make out that the trailing truck wheels are white-walled on this model. The polished cylinder front and back covers are a nice contrast to the black paint of the body, and you can see the cylinder cock piping below the cylinder. The chassis on the I-5 looks sharp with the unique white-walled drivers and the polished valve gear and rods. There is a high level of detail on the chassis, including the power reverser and linkage, mechanical lubricators, and the brake linkages and shoes. The tender on this streamliner is pretty nice, and the paint looks amazing on the body. The paint lines are crisp, and the colors contrast well on the tender body. Up top, you'll spot the tender light, water fill hatch, and a load of fine coal in the coal bunker. On the rear of the tender, you can get a better view of the tender light, marker lights, tender ladder, and the tender end sill detailing. There is nice hose, grab iron, step, and coupler cut lever detailing around the tender end sill. The tender rides on a pair of 3-axle Commonwealth trucks, and these were nicely finished with journal box and brake rigging detail. If you look close enough, you can also spot the pedestal binders under the journal boxes with the retaining bolts under the binder. The leaf spring detail is also visible in the cutouts of the truck's side frame. Overall, this was a nice model of the New Haven I-5 Hudson. These engines were recently delivered and are currently available from our friends at Trainworld for $679.99. We buy most of our trains from Trainworld and are always pleased with their service and quick shipping. Thank you. Broadway Limited has announced a Conductors Club, which is a members-based club that hobbyists can join for a fee of $29 a year. One of the perks of this club is a heavily discounted locomotive model in both HO scale and N scale each year. Broadway recently announced the late challengers in HO scale and the big boys in N scale will be run for members this year. For more information on the Conductors Club, you can visit Broadway Limited's website. We'd like to thank our friends at Broadway Limited Imports for sponsoring this product spotlight here on the Steam Channel. Until next time, we'll catch you on the rails.
Thanks for tuning in for this model train product review here on the Steam Channel. Get another high quality look at a new model by clicking on a video preview to your right.